UN response: Taliban must protect its people. When it comes with the healthcare system, there is great need there that we need to attend to. This is the statement of UNICEF official. Afghan really needs assistance. The healthcare system in Afghanistan is already fragile due to the recent chaos. The medical team is on hold due to security reasons. There is shortage of essential medical supplies to fight the COVID-19 pandemic, said WHO spokesperson Tariq Jasarevi. When it comes with the human rights, of the UN High Commission on Human Rights spokesperson Rupert Colville said that there are chilling reports of human rights abuses and of restrictions on the rights of individuals, especially women and girls, in some parts of the country captured over the past few weeks. Unfortunately, for the time being, the flow of information has been considerably disrupted, and we have not been in a position to verify the most recent allegations, added by Colville. Fortunately, the capital and the other last major cities to be captured, such as Jalalabad and Mazar-e-Sharif, were not subjected to prolonged fighting, bloodshed, or destruction. However, the fear instilled in a significant proportion of the population is profound, and given past history, thoroughly understandable. Colville continued, "The entire community is closely looking at the promises made by the Taliban. Taliban spoke people have said women can work and girls can go to school. They will grant an amnesty for those who work for the previous government. These promises of Taliban must be honored." The UN Refugee Agency, UN for High Commissioner for Refugees, asked the refugee host nations not to repatriate vulnerable Afghan nationals. In the wake of the rapid deterioration in the security and human rights situation in large parts of the country and the unfolding humanitarian emergency, UNHCR calls on states to halt possible returns of Afghan nationals who have previously been not to be in need of international protection, said spokesperson Shabia Mantoo. She continued that out of the hundreds of thousands of people that have been displaced, we have now 550,000 people displaced within the country, so they are still within Afghanistan. In recent weeks, the majority of those have fled in recent weeks, and 80% of those that are newly displaced are women and children. There was even reason to be slightly optimistic. UNICEF officer Mr. Ben Mesau, the stand of the Taliban is more or less the same, but we've seen small differences, especially in terms of girls' education. There are areas, part of the country, where they told us that they are waiting for guidance from their leadership, religious and political. In other places, they actually said that they want to see girls' education and school up and running, he continued. The country has already been severely affected by years of conflict and drought. There is nearly 400,000 people had been displaced since the beginning of the year as a result of ongoing violence, while more than 5 million others were already internally displaced and reliant on humanitarian aid, said by head of the International Organization for Migration, Antonio Vitorino. IOM reiterates that the safety and protection of civilians remains the number one priority and appeals to all parties to ensure unhindered access for all humanitarian actors, providing relief and much-needed assistance to affected populations who should be able to continue to exercise their fundamental rights, said Mr. Vitorino. IOM urges all parties to continue efforts to maintain dialogue and work towards a peaceful resolution of the situation, prioritizing the welfare of the Afghan people, said Mr. Vitorino. The United Nations in Afghanistan reiterate their commitment to stay and deliver aid to millions of people in need in the country. While some UN personnel that are not location-dependent has temporarily been relocated, the majority of humanitarian personnel are staying to support the humanitarian response in line with the principles of humanity, neutrality, impartiality, and independence. The humanitarian community, both the UN and the non-governmental organizations, remain committed to help people in Afghanistan. While the situation is highly complex, humanitarian agencies are committed to support vulnerable people in Afghanistan who need us more than ever. Statement made by Dr. Ramiz Alakvarov, United Nations DSRSG, Resident and Humanitarian Coordinator on UN. Please like and subscribe for more uploads like this.